What's up, guys? Today, we are comparing the 2018 MacBook Pro i7 with the 2017 MacBook Pro i5. Now, I'm doing this comparison specifically for those of you who are doing music production. I've been using the 2017 MacBook Pro i5 since it came out, and I've been really happy with it, but I need more hard drive space. I do a lot of 4K video editing for this channel, and I also really want to install the Native Instruments Complete Bundle, the Complete Ultimate, really big one. So first, I'm going to show you the specs on both these machines, and then we're going to compare their performance using music production software, specifically Ableton Live and Logic Pro. We're going to load them up, we're going to export a song, we're going to run some plugins. These have the identical images on them, they're running all the same software. Now that Apple started selling the 2018 MacBook Pros, you might be interested in finding a refurbished or a used 2017 MacBook Pro. And if you're looking for a 2017 MacBook Pro, I have a full comparison video comparing the two different models of the 2017 MacBook Pros, as well as a MacBook 12, the really thin MacBook. If you want to see that comparison, I'll put a link to it up here. Before we get into the specs, I have tons of music production tips on my channel. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button if you like this video. Now let's take a look at the specs of these MacBook Pros. So the 2017 MacBook Pro has a 3.1 gigahertz Intel Core i5. It's got 8 gigabytes of RAM, and the graphics are the Intel Iris Plus Graphics 650. The 2017 has also a 500 gigabyte SSD. Here's the 2018 MacBook Pro. It has a 2.7 gigahertz i7 processor, 16 gigabytes of memory, so I doubled the memory on this one, and it's running the Intel Iris 655, and I have 1 terabyte of storage. Okay, we're gonna start out by opening Ableton Live. This is Ableton Live 10 Suite. Very close, but the i7 was a little faster. Now let's open a song in Ableton. Both of these have the same song, and it's quite a heavy song. It's got a lot in it, so it should take them a little while to open. Here we go. This song has a number of samples in it, contact instruments. All right, i7 is a little faster. Now with this song open, why don't we just do a quick check on the CPU usage. Now that's over on the top right in Ableton Live. Playing them in the middle of the song, here we go. All right, so the i7 is showing about 22%, and the i5 it was jumping around a lot, but I would say around 25, peaking at 27%. Now keeping with the same song, let's do an export. Here we go. i7's done. All right, i5's done. They're pretty close to each other. All right, here's contact. I'm gonna open up the contact instrument called Signal. Signal is by Output. All right, so I've duplicated the contact track 10 times. So, well, we have 10 contact tracks, all identical, and I'm gonna play these together on both these machines, and let's see how they perform. All right, so the i5 is around 50% CPU usage, i7 peaking at about maybe low 40s, but staying pretty low. All right, for the next test, we're gonna test Logic Pro, and we're gonna start the application, and they're both opening the same project. So here we go. i7 a little faster as expected. All right, now for both of these machines, we're gonna do an export, or as Logic calls it, a share. I'm gonna do a share song to iTunes on both. Here we go. Small difference on the i7. This project is pretty small, so it doesn't take too long. Okay, for the next test, we're gonna open up GarageBand. Loading the same project. There you go, i7. And now we're doing export. These are identical songs. All right, for this final test, I've got Final Cut Pro open here, and I've got the same video file there, and I'm going to do an export or a share with this 4K video. It should be fairly quick, but let's see how they handle it. Here they go. i7 is done. And i5 is done now. Now, in my experience, after editing a few videos, 4K videos on the 2018 MacBook Pro i7, the longer videos I've done with a lot more editing in it have actually exported much quicker than the 2017 i5. Hey, what's up, guys? I shot this part later because there's a few things I do want to add. I've had the MacBook Pro for about 2 weeks now, and there's a few small things I wanted to mention. First, I do like the new keyboard. It's a lot quieter and it feels really comfortable to type on. I mean, it looks exactly the same as the old keyboard, but it just, I don't know, just feels better. This thing, when I'm here making my music in my studio back here, this thing is really loud. The fan on the i7, and I think this is specific to the faster processors, the i7 and the i9. All right, now, even though the fans are louder, it's not necessarily cooler. It's actually running really hot. If you keep this on your lap, even just for a couple minutes, you know, doing something like music production in Ableton or Logic, the fans start running and you start to really feel the heat. I really can't keep this thing on my lap for very long. So if you're looking for a recommendation, I highly recommend that you stick with the 2017 MacBook Pro and not the 2018, especially because right now you can probably get a really good deal on a 2017 MacBook Pro i7, fully spec'd out, big hard drive, and you get a really good deal on it compared to the brand new 2018s. You can find refurbished MacBook Pros on the Apple site. Also, I think B&H sells refurb. Oh, don't forget, back up your stuff. I had a problem with the USB ports on my 2017 MacBook Pro. They actually killed two of my hard drives and one of my SD card readers. I have a video about that telling you the full story. No matter what computer you're using, make sure you back up your stuff. All right, guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe. Keep making the music that you love on any machine. You can do it on anything you've got. I'll see you guys later.